What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to Fresh Women. This is part two of season two, chapter one. Previously, I did the first half. It was the beta 50, I believe it was called. So let's continue where we left off. All right, so we are exactly where we left off. We just finished having lunch or dinner with Chloe, and we're getting up to pay, and we found this wallet in our pants. It's not our wallet, obviously. And if you actually look at the name, it's not the name of our dad. Ooh, so what does that mean? Let's find out. I suppose it's my father's alias. You better pay, go straight back to the hotel. Wait, Simon, I haven't eaten yet. Can we have this to go, please? But then what were you doing? Sorry. This is the place. Some sketchy ass motel. No one booked the neighboring rooms. I asked. We could talk freely here. You really did think of everything. I never would have concerned myself with that sort of thing. So let me get this straight. Your father kidnapped Sam, and you got caught up in the middle of everything? Plus, your father happens to own the farm where you're hiding out? Yeah, that's basically the gist of it. But that's the weird part, no? When we searched my father's name before, that farm should have come up. Exactly. Maybe we didn't run a search for the right name. He was using a fake ID this whole time. Well, if the ID was in his wallet, I guess it doesn't hurt to run a search, right? Carlos Gonzalez, former Blue Jay. If you're going to creep out behind me, you could at least make yourself useful, no? After traveling for hours, I can really use a back massage. Let's give her a massage. If you want a massage so bad, you could just ask nicely. It's the least I could do for you after all you've done for me. Oh, that feels great. So, actually, there is a difference as well to this. I did download I do have the 4K version of this now. I believe the previous one I had was like the 720 or the 1080p. So this is the 4K version, and I have to say, it looks fantastic. Right here? Yep, keep it up. Glad you're enjoying yourself. I could stay here all night. Do you want to take this to the bed so we can keep on going? Cheeky. I think I better finish my research first, though. Ouch. Burn. You're right. Doesn't this scare you? Aren't you afraid you might learn something that doesn't sit well with you? A little. I've been looking for the truth for years. I need to know. But if everything Sam told me turns out to be true... You know, Simon... I think I know what you're feeling. If you want, we don't have to dig any further. No, we've come this far. Feels like we've gone too far to turn back now. I don't want to live with all that doubt. Okay, I see your point. Why don't you get some rest while I do my research? To be honest, a nap would be nice. You can get more comfortable if you like. Are you sure? I wouldn't want to distract you while you work. Wow, you are really focused on this. Okay then. Work first, then play. Chloe's a good friend. I should let her work. But I do get the impression that she might be hoping to do something else. I had it once already with Carolyn, though. Not like that would stop me. Good thing I showered before I left. Yeah, 100%. 100% something would happen here. Simon, I think I found something. You said your father was in prison in Mexico for a while. So I looked for some news stories in Spanish using his real name as well as his alias. Then I found this. Mass escape from penitentiary results in the death of 3 inmates. Look at the names of the deceased. Frederick Thomas Campbell. That's my father's name. He faked his own death? And now he goes by the name Carlos Gonzalez. That was one of the escapees who survived. So my father stole a dead man's identity? That's not all. I looked up the name Carlos Gonzalez, and he actually owns a farm here in town. From the pictures, it looks like the place you described. Yeah, that's where I was. That doesn't prove anything. My dad admitted that he was arrested, so he could still be telling the truth, right? There's one more thing. I searched again for Sam's name and found some of the contracts your father supposedly signed. None of them are signed Frederick. But they all have another name on them. Thomas. His middle name. When I looked up these contracts that other time, I didn't know his middle name, so I didn't give them a second thought. I thought it was someone else. But if you search for Thomas Campbell, without using the name Frederick, Thomas Campbell admits to fraud during police statement. His lawyer got him to openly admit the charges. So he knew everything. That's how it seems. From what you told me, it seems like Sam was telling the truth. Why? Why would he lie to me? You're going to have to ask them that. I'll go do that now. Simon, wait. It's too late to go out. I don't want to wait. I've been waiting my whole life. It's time to learn the truth, once and for all. Simon, you're not riding off on a bicycle in the middle of the night. And you shouldn't talk to him like this. You're too upset. You need to rest, and you need a plan. A plan? Yes, Simon. Your father lied to you, and he kidnapped Sam. It could be dangerous. My father isn't dangerous. Are you sure? Let's think this through one more time. He's already been arrested once. He stole someone's identity. He kidnapped a man. Sounds like a dangerous person to me. She's not wrong. Please, Simon. Why don't you spend the night here with me? Tomorrow, we can go back together. Then you won't have to go through this all alone. You're right. Better plan my next actions carefully. Better leave that all for tomorrow. Wow, that sucks. So his dad's a dick. Probably dangerous. Well, I was like, how can you really trust him, right? After what happened with the rest of your life. Good morning, sleepyhead. Good morning. What time is it? It's still early. Did you sleep well? Sure did look comfortable. Are you watching me sleep? I was. I enjoyed the sight of you sleeping with your hands stuffed down the front of your pants. What? I did not. Are you serious? It's fine. I can't imagine how tired you must have been. Anyway, I was just watching some cartoons. Wow, I loved this show when I was a little kid. Can't believe it's still on the air. Sure is. I used to watch it when I was a little girl, too. It looks like they're on the 14th season, and there are over 1,000 little monsters now. Did Art ever win any championship battles? Apparently no. That guy never wins anything of note. I think it's the coolest thing about this cartoon. The message is that we don't always have to win. Life goes on regardless. There's some truth to that. I called down for room service. Breakfast is served. There's bread, tea, coffee, and some fruit. It all looks really good. Pretty classy for a motel. It looks expensive. I should at least offer to chip in. Chloe, how much do you have to pay for all this? Let me help foot the bill. Don't worry, Simon. It's not that expensive. Alright then. Next one's on me. Deal. Next time we need to cross state lines and rent a room to investigate something, I'll let you pay. Agreed. Fresh news. What's that? Breaking news? What could have happened? Jeez, that's loud. For me, that's loud. We interrupt your regular scheduled programming to bring you this breaking news. Oh, that's the house. The house in the background. Isn't that Lily's house? We've just been informed that corporate manager Sam Alderson has officially gone missing. Let's bring in Sam's wife, Lily, for an exclusive word about the incident. Please help me find my husband. The last I heard from Sam was last night. He was supposed to be a special event, but no one saw him there. They found his car in the parking lot the next morning. His cell phone is off, and I haven't heard a word from him for a whole day now. He's never done anything like this before. I'm afraid something might have happened to him. If anyone has any information, please don't hesitate to call. I can only hope someone finds him safe and sound. Thank you very much, Lily. Stay tuned for a regular news report, when we will update you on any further developments. Ratushi, Thunderbolt! Was he walking Pokemon? Oh, Simon. This sounds serious. I know. I need to tell my father about this. I have to convince him to stop this madness and release Sam. Are you sure that's really your best option? I am. You can wait for me here if you'd like. Not a chance. You want me to miss out on the action? Besides, I'd be worried sick the whole time. I'm coming with you. Thank you. Maybe I should call Lily and let her know that Sam is fine. Oof. To call Lily or not to call Lily? Ooh, that is a tough, tough question. Which, if I call her, I would get points with her. And we already are on her path, I think. So let's do it. Let's see what happens. I just need to make a call first. Okay, I'll wait outside. I need to think carefully about what I'm going to say. I don't want to end up incriminating my own father, even though he's totally guilty. Simon, why are you calling? I can't exactly talk right now. Lily, there's something I need to tell you. About Sam. What about Sam? What do you know? Do you know where he is? Talk to me, Simon. What should I tell her? Just enough to calm her down or tell her everything? Ooh. Wow, that is actually a big choice. Tell her enough to calm her down or tell her everything? If you tell her everything, you're literally throwing your dad under the bus and screwing him completely. If you tell her enough, well, she's going to hate you. You know what? Screw the dad. He disappeared. He could have said something. Let's screw him. Tell her everything. He was kidnapped by my father. I'm with them. Simon, what are you trying to say? I didn't want to get involved in this, but here I am. I just wanted to let you know. I just saw you on TV. Does that mean your father's alive? What about Sam? Is he okay? Where are you? We were out on a ranch in the middle of nowhere. I don't know the location because there's no phone coverage out there. I came to town so I can use my phone. I'm at a motel. I'll send you the address here. I hope that'll help. Thank you, Simon. I know how hard this must be for you. Please don't let anything bad happen to Sam. I'm going back there now. I'm going to try to fix things. I have to go, Lily. Simon? Simon! Done. This way, at least she knows he's alive. I hope that will help calm her down. Now it's time to go fix this. This is bad. You know, I know things seem pretty crazy right now, but we need to keep our cool. Let's think this through and try to work out what's our best way forward. Okay, can we do that? I always have to remember that there are people out there who care for me. Thank you for that, Chloe. And yeah, I think we can manage that much. Great! Now, how are we going to get out there? All we got is your bicycle. We'll ride double! You're kidding, right? You're not kidding. Are you sure this is going to work? Yep, it'll be smooth sailing. It's not going to be smooth sailing. Oh dear, Simon! And I love how clean the, how clean it looks. Looks great. How far out is this place? Are we there yet? It's that house right over there. Simon? There's a police car parked out front. No way. Simon, wait! What are you doing? Stop! Chloe? It's too late, Simon. If you go in there, you'll only be dragging your own name into this. We better just go and pretend we were never here. That's literally not possible. It'll be better for everyone. You can still find out where they are, and you'll live to ask whatever questions you want to some other time. Fine. Let's get out of here. Stop right there, whoever you are. Would you like to tell me what the two of you are doing way over here? Tell him about Fred's wallet. That's the easiest way to cover our butts, right? Like, then my immediate reaction is like, you know what? Cover it. Well, we found this wallet on our way here. Simon? We were debating whether or not to give it to you. Then why turn around? I don't know. We didn't want to get in the way of whatever you guys were doing back there. Where did you find this? Just a ways up the road. I'm going to have to confiscate this, kid. Suit yourself. We're going to hand it over anyways. The owner of that wallet, is he the guy you're looking for? Is he dangerous? That's police business. You better be going on your way. This isn't a safe place to be riding. Simon, what did you just do? What was I supposed to do? I couldn't just say I was off to visit my father. You could have come up with something else. And then tried to find out what was going down after. Or at very least, we could have asked for a ride back. My ass is going to be sore for days if I get back on that bike. Sorry about that. You think they arrested him? We'll just have to wait and find out. Screw him. He's a liar. We're here. Oh, thank God. My back is killing me. Same. But I was the one doing all the pedaling. Mine was probably twice as bad. True. Well, what do we do now? The room is still under my name. I think the best we can do now is go in, check on the news, and wait. Wait for what? I texted Dylan to ask him to come get us. You serious? Yep. Why'd you do that, Chloe? I had to ride a bus and now a bike. I think I've earned a little comfort on the way back. And besides, you two could use the return trip to make your peace. Did Dylan agree to all that? He doesn't know you're here. Oh, that's gonna go well. What? I didn't want to risk him not coming to pick me up. Can't believe you did that. You can take the bus if you prefer. I'm gonna go inside, take a shower, and get some rest while we wait. I don't really like the idea of having to talk to Dylan right now. But she's right. We better get this sorted out sooner rather than later. It's Lily. I should answer. Lily? Simon! I'm so glad you picked up. Please tell me you're with Sam. I'm sorry, Lily. The police beat me to them. The police cruiser was already there by the time I got to the ranch. Now both Sam and my father are missing. I think my father must have taken Sam with him when he made his escape. Where did he take Sam? I don't know. Simon, please, you have to tell me the truth. I swear, Lily, I wouldn't lie to you. I have no idea where they might have gone. My father left me in the dark. And left me behind again. You sure about that, Simon? Yeah, I am. Well, if you do think of anything that might be of some help, please let me know. Don't worry. You'll be the first to find out if I think of anything. You promise? Yeah, I promise. Thank you, Simon. What are you going to do? I'll just head home and wait for something to turn up. If you want to stop by later, it might be easier if I explain everything face to face. I'd like that. Take care, Simon. You too, Lily. I hope the cops can find them soon. That's all I've got for her. Better head inside and wait with Chloe. Dylan should be here soon. Oh boy, that's not going to be fun. Oh, there he is. This is not going to be cool. Hey, I had no idea it was this far out, Chloe. Care to tell me how you ended up at World's End? I came to help a friend. There's room for one more in your car, right? Chloe. You could have let me know he needed a ride, too. We're kind of not on speaking terms. I know. That's exactly why I didn't say anything. Besides, this will be the perfect opportunity for you two to settle things. Come on, Simon. Hey, Dylan. Hey, Simon. Hop in. Well, at least he's being cool about it. This is gonna get awkward. Yeah, exactly. So, don't you want to know what we came all the way out here for, Dylan? If you guys cross paths with another bear without me, I'm gonna be pretty upset. I found my father. What? How'd that happen? Where is he? You don't seem all that happy about it, though. Why the long face? He took off again. Huh? What do you mean, took off? Tell me everything, dude. Well, he doesn't know everything. But his past. I don't even know where to start. Well, the short version is that Simon's father kidnapped Sam and ended up bringing Simon along for the ride. But then, the police found out where they were hiding, and Simon's dad bailed on him. Chloe! What? I'm just telling it like it is. I'm sorry, bro. Bro? Does that mean... Nope. Just sort of slipped out. Still mad at you. Dylan! Ow! He's just fishing for some long apology at this point, Simon. Bro, what do I have to do to make things right between us? I can't believe you basically kidnapped a dude without me. That's even cooler than the run-in with the bear. If you want to be my bro, you've got to stop leaving me out of things. Alright, bro, I won't. That's a promise. Start texting me back. Oh, right. He left me a bunch of messages after that frat party. Dude, I'm sorry. I swear I was going to reply, but then there was the ball, not to mention the kidnapping, and I sort of forgot. You know what? I'll text you back right now. Oh my lord, he's actually texting him too. Sorry, bro, but I'm driving. It's my turn to ignore your text for a while. You said bro again! Because you're my bro! Oh, that was flippin' easy. I missed you, bro. Missed you too. Aw, now kiss and make up. What? Not happening, Chloe. I tried. How long until we get there? My phone says 3 hours and 20 minutes. It'll be a little while. So sit back and enjoy the ride. Alright, we finally have another character besides Chloe. We have arrived. Finally. Do you need a place to stay tonight, Simon? Oh, right. I really need to find a new apartment. I do, actually. Then come on in. See you at class tomorrow, bro. Later, bro. Like, it made it so easy. Like, come on, man. Home sweet home. What's wrong? I don't know. That was also intense, so unexpected. Then suddenly, we're back here again. Back to normal life? Yeah, back to normal life. But that's a good thing, isn't it? You wouldn't want to spend the rest of your days running from the police, would you? Good point. Simon, I think what you really need is a bit of R&R. That's definitely something I can help you with. We can go upstairs and stretch out on my bed together. Interesting. I'm so tired. I figured I'd just be sleeping on the couch. What is this? Her way of inviting me for some fun? Follow Chloe or stay on the couch? Well, come on. You know we gotta go to Chloe's room. Come on. You know, Chloe, you're right. Everyone needs some time to unwind. Let's head upstairs then. Follow me. Remember, if you actually watched the original playlist, we did have a chance to sleep with Chloe already, and we did turn her down, because we completely ignored her basically all game. Finally, some peace and quiet. After all that drama, it's good to be back in the big city. Huh. Does that mean the countryside doesn't suit you? I think I've had my fill of it for a while. Oh, is that so? What a shame. What am I supposed to do with this outfit then? It's pure country. Well, when you put it like that, I guess the countryside does look good on you. I figure you see things my way. Maybe you'd like to take a closer look at the outfit. You might find you like seeing me in it. Or maybe out of it. Hold your horses, cowboy. You gotta enjoy the show first. Well, we definitely just slept with Chloe, so apparently your previous doesn't matter, so that's fun. If you want to see it, and I do recommend it, because it's actually pretty long and pretty interesting, and there are some important choices you have to make during it, which obviously I can't show you. But yeah, to know what they are, you have to play the game and find out. Or sign up for my Patreon. There's a link in the description below. And the Patreon will be showing all the full videos like this with all the nudity and all the goodies. Let's continue. Huh? Who could that be? At this hour? I have to be careful not to wake Chloe. Hello? Simon, is that you? Yeah. Wait, Dad? Where are you? Where's Sam? Don't worry about Sam. He's fine. I'm fine too, thanks for asking. Dad, I know, son. You're confused. I'm outside your girlfriend's house. What? How'd you get here? Are you following me? Just come down. I'll explain everything. I think it's a little late for explanations. Son, just come down, please. Tell me one thing first. Did you kill Charlie? That's complicated. I'll be waiting for you. Complicated, huh? That's not a good sign. He hung up. Guess I have no choice but go down and see him. Wait, Lily asked me to keep her posted. Maybe I should tell her where Dad is. It would be so easy to just text her my location. But she seemed really serious about finding Sam, even going as far as getting on the news and calling the police. I don't know what she might do with my location. You know what? We've gone all in on her. Let's do it. Sent. That's all I can do for now. Dad? Where's Sam? I told you already. He's fine. Okay, then start talking. We should move to a safer location. I'm not getting into another vehicle with you anytime soon. Just tell me. It'll be better this way. Did you kill Susan's husband? I found out he was keeping an eye on everything Sam did. In other words, he knew about all the contracts. Okay, but you also knew exactly what contracts you were signing. Yes, I did. But Charlie was the only one who could undo them. What? Just like that? Yes, all of this could have just been avoided if you just voided the contracts. But of course, you already know that. No, I had no idea. But you did. Before your accident, you found my notes, didn't you? You found out what I was doing, and you went to talk to Charlie about it. That would explain why you were so angry at him. What do you... Then he had his accident. Wait, is it really an accident? I was just trying to scare him. But you did much more than that. It really was an accident, son. Dad, the police... Shit, it must have been Lily. Lily? What are you talking about? I basically told her you were here. Basically? Why would you do a dumb thing like that? She wants to find Sam. That man doesn't deserve your pity. I can stop her from leaving if I just grab that key. Dad, what are you doing, son? You should turn yourself in and settle everything with the police. If you give yourself up, I'm sure things will turn out all right. What? You're aware I already escaped from jail once, aren't you? Do you know what'll happen if I get arrested again? Lily has connections. She'll be able to help somehow. Don't do this to me, son. Give him the key or keep the key. You know what? This guy made his own bed. Kidnapping me. Kidnapping Sam. He killed Charlie. He lied about everything. Screw this guy. Keep the key. I can't give you this. Let's do right this time, Dad. I thought you forgave me, son. I have. That's why I want the best for you. And the best thing for you is to surrender. Everything will work itself out, Dad. The most important thing is that you're here now. All right, son. I've always known this day would come. I can't delay it any longer. You failed, Dad. It's time for you to get back up and take the first step in the right direction. I was expecting him to, like, pull out a gun or something. They're here. Frederick Thomas Campbell, you're under arrest for kidnapping Samuel Olderson. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have a right to an attorney. If you cannot, it's fine. I know my rights, officer. I won't resist. Can I at least say goodbye to my son? Oh, is that the same officer? Be quick about it. Dad, son, I'm proud to see you've become a man. Tell your mother I love her. I will, Dad. And we'll visit you together. Thanks, son. I love you. Come on, let's go. Bye, Simon. You did the right thing, kid. Did I? I'm going to need a statement from you, too. But that can wait. Yeah, he did it to himself. Hey, bro. Dylan, what are you? I live right over there. Did you forget? I saw the car and got curious. I heard everything. Are you alright? Am I? Yeah. I am. It's finally over. He's going to jail, but at least he's alive. You're the kind of guy who sees the glass half full, aren't you? I'm sorry it didn't go down as you expected it would. It's like a weight has been lifted off my shoulders, though. I'm glad to hear that. Oh, you're here too. Of course I am. We're always here for you, Simon. Thanks, guys. Why don't the three of us go inside? I'll order something to eat. How about pizza? Pepperoni? What? Just something from my childhood. Let's head inside. Referencing the other part. Yeah. And then, while I was thinking about what to say to the policeman, Simon grabbed his father's wallet out of his pocket and said, we found this wallet in the middle of the road. Man, I can't believe I missed all that. And then what happened? The officer told us to scram. We had to ride all the way back on a bicycle. Dude, please promise me you'll never leave me out of these things again. Never. We're bros to the end. Bros to the end. Guys, it's getting kind of late. I think I'm going to go upstairs and get some rest. You two make yourselves at home, though, all right? That's okay. I think I'm going to go, too. See you tomorrow. It's good to be back. Even if it is on Chloe's couch. I really need to find a place to stay. Maybe I should take the job the villa offered me. Who's calling at this hour? Lily? She must be worried about Sam. I completely forgot all about that. Hello? Lily? Simon, sorry to call so late. Did I wake you? No, I was up. Look, Lily, about Sam. I really have no idea where he might be. He's here with me, Simon. We're at the hospital. The hospital? Is everything all right? He's pretty banged up. Some scratches and bruises. The doctors are having a look at him, though, just to make sure it's nothing serious. But we should be heading home soon. I'm glad to hear he's okay. So, I just called to say thank you for everything, Simon. I just did what anyone would do. I need to go. We'll talk later, okay? I'd like to repay you for what you've done. Talk soon, then. Bye, Lily. Glad to hear Sam's okay. What? It's Susan. Simon, are you awake? I really need to speak with you. Text me back as soon as you see this, okay? Hey, Susan. I'm awake. Is something the matter? I need to speak with you in person. Can you come see me? Now? Yes. Okay, then. I'm on my way. Look at Susan Wong with me at this hour. It's getting really late. It's so important that I can't wait till tomorrow. Simon, is that you? Come in. I heard about what happened. How are you holding up? I'm fine. Thanks for asking. Are you sure about that? I mean, after everything with your dad, Sam, and the police? I don't think I've wrapped my head around everything yet. I see. Well, I just wanted to say I'm sorry if I was too hard on you, okay? I want you to know that you can count on me whenever you need me. Does that mean I'm not fired? Of course you're not. Thank you, Susan. Holy crap, who's... Now who? Are you expecting someone else? No. Could that be then? Would you like me to get the door for you? Please. That's strange. Who's this guy? Oh, Jesus. What in the... Thought I might find you here, Simon. We need to talk. Gallery content unlocked. And that is actually the end of season 2, episode 1. If you see in the picture here on the screen, that's where we are. Unfortunately, there is nudity on that picture, so I can't really show that, unfortunately. But yeah, that is actually it. Wow. So Sam is beat to shit, but he's there. How you just talked to Lily on the phone. So the time it took you to talking to Lily to you getting to Susan's house, somehow he got out of the hospital and got there as well. That's crazy. Anyways, yeah, interesting first episode. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how this turns out. So we turned her dad in. I can definitely see all the different branches for this. Again, so we slept with Chloe. And that was the only sex scene in this game, in this episode. This half the episode. You can turn your dad in, you can not turn him in. How much you tell Lily will probably affect a whole bunch in the future. You have like 3 different times there. I could definitely see like for season 2, there could be a whole lot of different branches to this. And that really excites me. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoy it. Again, there is a Patreon. If you want to watch the full episode with all the nudity and all the goodness that goes on with Chloe. And yeah, thank you for watching. Hit that thumbs up, hit that subscribe button. And I'll catch you all in the next one.